super annoyed right now. I went and tried to do my blood work and glucose test, but it was so freakishly busy. Like, everyone and their mother was there, literally. Like, there was someone who pulled up and was in like an SUV, and literally like three kids, like one came out of the front seat, and like really young kids, like maybe 4 or 5. One came out the front seat, three came out the back seat, and then one little girl walks over to the back, opens up the trunk, and literally 4 more little kids walked out. So, like, we're talking little kids too. Like, I don't even know. I feel like they should still be in a booster seat. I think my nephew is, and my nephew's bigger than them. So yeah, everyone was there, and it just kept getting busier and busier and busier. I prepped my meal and everything. Like, I had what I ate last time so that I, you know, did good on the test, but unfortunately I couldn't do it today. So that really sucks. Like, my head was in the game. I was feeling a little bit weird. And what's weird is, like, already this morning has been really strange. Like, I woke up, like, I was in an okay mood, but like the dogs were driving me nuts, and I don't know if it's hormones or what, but like I have like no patience for them lately. And then I'm getting ready, about to start getting dressed, and all of a sudden I look over and Athena had thrown up, like, a lot, just randomly. So I just, like, was cleaning all morning and was, like, getting myself together and just kept telling myself, you know what, we'll get our head back in the game and still have a good day. And then waited at this place for, it would have been over an hour, I've been waiting there, and still had another 30 minutes to wait, and I just wasn't gonna do it. All right, so I came back. I left and was like, you know what, screw it. Like, I just want to get this over with. So I came back, drank the drink. It just kind of makes your heart race a little bit. Like, right now, like, I drank it. I just finished. I get to sit in my car, which is awesome. Last time I didn't get to, but I think I'm going to walk and sit on the bench for a little bit and just kind of walk around too, and try not to walk too much, but just enough to kind of get rid of this feeling. But, I almost was like not gonna do it. I like went in and was like, is there a way I can just get the drink so I can at least drink it? Because if I have to wait an hour anyway, just let me like have the drink at least in my system. So she was so nice and she actually did it for me. But it's getting so late, it's lunchtime. I'm starving already. So this was probably not a very good idea, but we're gonna try it. I just wanna get it over with, you guys. Like, you have no idea. I'm just dying to be done with this, so. This is my story. I left. I went to Publix. I got bread. Went home and gave the dog another treat and came here. Poor baby is just bouncing around in there. So just hope my body does well at this so I don't have to come back for the 3 hour. So just want to update you guys. I did come back and swindled my way in. Was like, I've been here since 10 and it's almost 12. And I think I was even there sooner than 10 even. There's a lot of people who were there originally who still had not been called back. I think the worst part about this right now is the acid reflux. The drink tastes good. I got the orange one again, and it's, I'm telling you, it does not taste bad at all. I don't like taste anything bad, but it does give you the jitters a little bit. So yeah, I have to wait here for an hour and hopefully I do okay. It's like busy in there. So she's like, you can go sit in your car if you want, because she knows like how busy it is and how you don't really feel good after you take the drink. So the last thing you want to do is be in a room full of like a ton of people. But I'm doing it, guys. Poor thing, he's just like twisting around in there. Sorry, baby. Now to wait. Alrighty, y'all. I did it. I'm so glad I came back to do the test and didn't just like completely give up, because now I'm done and I don't have to worry about it. Once I swindled that girl into letting me take the test, everything went like smooth. It's only just getting your name, like them giving you the paperwork to take your test, that takes forever. I think today is just like an extra busy day because everyone was like, what is going on today? Why is today so crazy? So I'm done. Fingers crossed, pray for me that I pass the test, because I do not want to have to come back for the 3 hour. But honestly, guys, like I wish I could speak for everyone and I wish everyone had the same experience, but this test, like, really, Google like ruins it for a lot of pregnant women. I remember the last time I took it, I was terrified to take this test. Terrified. My family was like tired of talking to me about it.
guys, it's really okay.
Don't let Google freak you guys out. Is one, so I need some food.
Okay, so I'm home and I'm ready for lunch. Everything went good, blood is drawn. It's definitely sore. I don't know if she was new or not, but this is definitely more of the painful one. For some reason with her, it took a little longer. She just didn't get the vein in the right angle or something like that, I don't know. So she had the patient she had before me, the same thing happened with him. I'm just wondering if it was like maybe an off day or something, but it definitely was the more painful one because it lasted longer and it was, I don't know, she was great though. I loved her. Like I've always, the location like really sucks because everyone and their mom goes there, but like the people have always been nice. I've always enjoyed handling and dealing with people. I think mainly it's because like they deal with kind of mean people all day. Like people just get grouchy there. Everyone's fasting, they're getting their blood drawn, they're nervous, they get grouchy because they have to wait. So I think they're used to grumpy people. So whenever they see someone who's just like in a good mood, I think it just makes them in a good mood and they're fun. So I've always had really good experience with them. So I have no complaints.
Had some lunch. I'm gonna drink some coffee. I'm starting to already feel a little bit like just sleepy, but I think it's literally just cause I haven't had any coffee. But I went ahead and I came home and I'm done driving. Like I keep coming home and leaving. Hung out here and I was like, you know what? I'm so hungry. I'm gonna make a sandwich. And then I was like, no, I'm gonna go to Subway. So I left again. So the poor dogs, they're like, mom, just sit still. Cause I kept coming and going. And so finally I got some Subway and it was delicious. And I ended up getting a cookie as well. But I'm gonna eat that a little bit later once some of this sugar goes away because I don't want to overdo it. But yeah, I feel fine. I've done fine so far. I've been talking to my friend Natalie. She actually had to do the glucose test today too. And then a couple other women who I had been following on Instagram, they took their test today too. So I'm just like thinking of everyone, like just hoping everyone, you know, had a fine experience. Thinking of Natalie, hoping she had a decent experience. Yeah, I'm gonna go make some coffee because I'm exhausted and I need to get to work. I cannot believe it's already 3 o'clock. I've spent the entire day at this stupid lab place. So I'm watching Teen Mom. I haven't watched last week's episode yet. I ended up having that crash earlier and I had a massive headache. But I drank coffee and I feel good now. I still feel a little bit tired, but honestly, coffee doesn't really wake me up anymore. So it just kind of makes me feel alive, but it doesn't really wake me up as far as give me energy. But thankfully it did take away the headache. I haven't had any Tums today and I think I'm gonna try and go for a while without taking Tums. Wish me luck that I do well on it because I just feel like, even on the back of the thing, it says do not take longer than like a week. Do not take maximum dose for longer than a week. And I just don't wanna have to constantly be taking it. So I know it's supposed to be like a safe thing to do, but I haven't taken any Tylenol. I haven't taken any kind of medication other than Tums. And I don't want that to be like a new thing for me. Thankfully the headache is gone because that was starting to be a little bit crippling. I did not like that massive headache. And I remember last time I had a really bad headache too. And I think I took like a nap and then I felt fine. But that was because also I wasn't drinking coffee then. And now I am. So I think the caffeine really helped. And I also looked online to some other girls and they said that when they drank caffeine, even though they cut caffeine out of their diet, when they drank caffeine, it made the headache go away. So there's a tip for you guys if you guys end up getting a headache after the test. You guys have been asking for hauls. Like I mentioned that I was going maternity shopping, which I need to write some people, but I had posted that that's what I was doing. I was buying maternity clothes and maternity clothes shopping. And someone had mentioned, oh, are you gonna do a haul? And that's actually a good idea. I wouldn't mind showing like some of the maternity clothes that I've gotten and see if maybe you guys might be interested in seeing that video, just because I have gotten some maternity clothes and maybe you guys would be interested, especially because mine are like pajamas. They're like so comfortable. They're not actually pajamas, but like, here comes acid reflux. It comes and then it goes away. But like literally they feel like pajamas. Go back down. By the way, another thing, remember like weeks ago, like I would say over a month ago, maybe even almost 2 months ago, I dropped Pringles on my toe and I turned my toe black. It's still black. Like it still has like a big black mark and it's like all around my toenail. It's disgusting. I cannot believe like literally after like a month or two, the mark's still there. It's definitely like faded a little bit, but it's still like really, really noticeable. I'm hoping my results come in within the next few days. So I'm hoping I can like check it. And then if I do like happen to fail the test, I can go back in again this week and get it over with. Cause I just want this crap over with or done with. I just wanna be able to like go into the third trimester, which is in 2 weeks. I just wanna be able to go into the third trimester like feeling good. Like this week and next week are my last 2 weeks of the second trimester, which is kind of sad because
I was warned, and modesty if you're watching this, I was warned to make sure I got everything done in the second trimester, and unfortunately, just the way that the baby shower is laid out, I couldn't get the nursery done, and I was warned that I'm gonna be miserable doing the nursery in the third trimester. So I did not take the advice, but it was kind of like I couldn't take it type of thing. And one super nice thing is we have so much family around that if we wanted, like, if we were gonna do anything crazy in the nursery, which we're not, but if we were gonna do anything crazy, you know, my husband can paint the nursery on his own. He doesn't need my help for that. I mean, I probably will like help like set things up, but I probably won't be in the room when he's painting. So he doesn't need help with that. And then setting up furniture or anything like that, like, he really doesn't need help for that either because we have so much family around here.
Hey guys, it is Tuesday and I've been working all morning, having a pretty decent day today. I am so thankful I went back yesterday and made sure I got my test done yesterday. I just wanted to be able to just enjoy the rest of the week. And if I had that stupid test on my mind all day yesterday, it would have easily ruined my day. And then also like today, thinking I would have had to have left and spent the day there again because I couldn't have made an appointment. Because I don't know if I mentioned it, but I tried making an appointment. I've known about needing to do my blood work this week for over a month, and I don't do it in my office. I don't know if that was a little bit confusing too. I don't do it in my normal doctor's office. So anyways, I've known about needing to do this week for a month, exactly 1 month. And the day that I found out I needed to take the test or schedule the test, I went to try and make an appointment, and the entire week, for whatever reason, was like blacked out. So I don't know, like I guess everyone needed a test this week, but because I saw that and I knew the last time I went, I didn't use an appointment. That's why I went yesterday. And I definitely have learned that Mondays are gonna be super busy days. So if I don't have an appointment, I don't think I'll go on Mondays anymore. I'll probably stick to Tuesdays, Wednesdays, or Thursdays. But yeah, it was crazy yesterday. But I feel really good today. I don't have a headache anymore, thankfully. I ended up being able to get rid of it last night just from like relaxing, just chilling and drinking a lot of water and having some food. I was able to get rid of my headache yesterday. So if you guys experience that after your glucose test, I just definitely recommend taking it easy, you know, lay down if you have to, and you know, just do what you can to get rid of that headache because it sucks. But it is a new day today. I'm feeling really good today. I've been working on combating acid reflux still. I don't know, that is, I would have to say, my number one symptom is acid reflux. It is so annoying, it's so frustrating, but I am trying. I don't want to have to take Tums, and I've said it so many times, like I'm trying to get off the Tums. I don't want to take them. And so what has been working for me, whenever I get the acid reflux, I've been drinking water. And even if it's just a sip, as long as something is like going down my throat, it tends to push it down. It does eventually come back up to my throat, but at least I'm able to push it down for a little bit. 20, 30 minutes later, it comes back, take some sips of water, and it goes back down. So I'm hoping eventually, like, my body can figure out how to fight it on its own and I don't have to take Tums every day. But I really, really, really want to stop taking them because I just feel like, although they're gonna fix this problem, they're gonna cause another problem. And that's how I feel with any medication. Or even if you eat a lot of food, like, I feel like, great, it's probably good for like this, but if you have it too much, it's gonna cause problems. And just too much of anything causes problems. So I'm trying to avoid, you know, possibly getting kidney stones, or I don't know if it affects your gallbladder or not. I've heard of a lot of women having gallbladder issues while they're pregnant. So I just want to try and avoid it as much as I can. So that's pretty much what I've been doing, is trying to just make sure I'm drinking water. And it's knocking two birds out with one stone because I'm getting the water I'm supposed to be getting. And then also, of course, I'm keeping the acid from coming into my mouth. Let me know if there's any like makeup products that are new that you guys would like a review on before you run out and buy it. Just let me know if you guys have any that you want to see, or baby products or hauls or whatever you want to see. Just let this girl know. But it's lunchtime, so let's go eat some lunch.
So for lunch, I'm having a chicken salad sandwich. I'm not sure what I'm gonna have for a side yet, but I will figure that out. I had to prepare the chicken salad, obviously, on the plate, so that's why it's all messed up. But basically, it is just canned chicken with mayo and a little tiny bit of mustard. I want to add something a little bit different to it. I usually don't like mustard, but it's like, you know what? We're gonna try it. So did that, a little bit of salt and pepper, and now I got me a yummy sandwich.
Well, this is fun. We are under tornado watch now. At least it's not tornado warning, at least it's tornado watch, but still, probably should get away from the window. Lightning has been striking like out of nowhere. Like yesterday, it just came out of nowhere. But it is like really dark outside, and
really not very fun looking. I still have a few things I should probably do before I take a chance of the power going out, but it is like really nasty out. And I heard that like on Thursday or something, there's supposed to be like this wild storm that like never happens, some weird, I don't even know what to call it. I guess it's like a certain type of storm that's supposed to pass through on Thursday, but I don't know if that's changed. But every day it's been pretty stormy, not just like rainy, but like storms. Usually those don't gear up until closer to summer.
So right now I'm waiting for this storm to pass. I don't think we're under tornado warning anymore. We went from watch to warning, but it's still pretty nasty outside. So I'm waiting for it to pass because I need to go grocery shopping. We need food. And I used to always go with my husband, but I think I'm gonna start making that like my chore, because when I go with my husband, we never get anything good. We always just get like the bare minimum. And being pregnant, that just does not work. I need to have some food. I'm gonna go grocery shopping once the storm ends, hopefully before I have to start dinner. If not, I'll just go tomorrow. But I wanna get like carrots and celery and bananas, and we already have like grapes and apples and stuff like that, but like I need food. I'm so hungry, and all I want right now is like a plate of carrots and celery, like with some ranch dip. That's all I want. So I'm waiting for the storm to pass because I really don't want to go in the storm. It is starting to lessen a little bit. I literally just look in the pantry and there's like chips and stuff like that, but like I don't want any of it. And there's like a ton of crackers. Crackers aren't an aversion right now, but whenever I see the crackers, it takes me back to first trimester, and I don't really want to be there, but I also don't want to get rid of them because I hear in the third trimester sometimes your like morning sickness will come back a little bit. So I want to keep them instead of like just throw them away. So I'm holding on to them. And then we have 2 cases of ginger ale. I'm gonna get a little bit more work done, and then it sounds like the storm is passing, so I'm gonna try and get to the store before everyone else does.
So I thought I would do a quick grocery haul now that I am home. I went ahead and kind of focused on mainly like buy one get one stuff. Bagels are like my sick obsession before pregnancy, but I'm just gonna say pregnancy. But anyways, I got 2 bagels, cinnamon raisin and blueberry. Got some celery. I went ahead and got a small thing of ranch because I still have a little bit of ranch left and it wasn't buy one get one, so I just went ahead and got a small one. I got buy one get one free Texas toast. I got 2 new creamers that were buy one get one, sweet cream and Irish cream. They did not have a good selection. I don't think I like Irish cream, but oh well, this was the only selection really I had. I got 3 yogurts. I got blended peach, blended cafe latte, and what is fun? Blended black cherry. I got 2 things of Chips Ahoy cookies. He's not gonna be the happiest that I bought these, but I don't care. I got some bananas just cause he tries not to eat anything like this. If it's in the house, he eats it. So he always gets mad when I buy cookies. That's why. I got carrots. I got 2 things of Raisin Bran cause they were buy one, get one. I got some milk. We don't have any milk in the fridge, which is crazy because we always have 2 gallons of milk in the fridge from Costco. And I drank all of it, so I had to get some more milk. And then I went ahead and got some tea bags because I have read that tea is a good thing to drink when you're pregnant, like just having a thing of sweet tea. So I got the tagless ones because the way I make mine, the tags are always in the way. So I thought I may switch over to tea on some days, maybe cut out the coffee or something and then just have some sweet tea during the day, especially with it being the first day of spring and with summer coming. Tea is my jam during this time of year. So picked up that, and that is everything.
Hey guys, what a wild past couple of days. I have a couple things to update you guys on. When's the last time I talked to you guys? Monday, maybe? Probably Monday, but I guess we'll just start with yesterday. So I do not have makeup on, my hair is a hot mess. I've had a rough couple of days. Not totally terrible, but just like really busy. So yesterday we decided to finally bring in the furniture from the guest room. So we have the bed now in my office. We brought in also the dresser that was in there. We set up our whole little thing over there. But anyway, we went ahead and we finally did that. So everything that was in the guest room, which was our nursery, which is now going to be the nursery, is now in here. We have a bunch of little knickknacks in there, like just little stuff that was kind of like our storage area for the longest time. So we have quite the project when it comes to that room. But we've already got it started. This was a huge chore we wanted to get done, and it was like so quick. So we did that yesterday. And then once that was done, I got work done and everything, but we went to Costco. We bought like tons of diapers because Costco has a sale on diapers. So we bought a bunch just in case at the baby shower we don't get very much. At least
we have these. Before that, I think it was on Wednesday or something, because today's Friday, if I didn't say, today is Friday. On Wednesday, my memory card broke. I planned on having a vlog up yesterday, which I have completely edited up until, like, I can't access my SD card, or I couldn't. I have like a temporary fix going on right now, so I hope it sticks. I really hope so. I would hate to have to like get a new card or whatever, which I'm probably gonna have to do anyway, just so I have a card I can rely on for when baby comes. But yeah, so that happened too. So no vlog went up yesterday, but hopefully today I can get one up. So yeah, we did the Costco trip and everything. And on the way to Costco, I ended up getting my results back from the glucose test. And everything came back normal. I passed and everything. So I don't know. I'm hoping my doctor doesn't decide to still make me do the 3 hour, because I've been reading that some women, like every office has a different cutoff number. And that's really frustrating. And so I don't know if my office is gonna decide to still have me do the 3 hour test, because I passed. Like, we'll put that out there. I passed the glucose test. So I just kind of had like an emotional day yesterday. My hormones definitely took over yesterday. Pretty much a lot of yesterday and last night. I just felt really just kind of sad, and I don't know why. I just felt very sad. And then today, all of a sudden, I like had a breakdown in the morning, just because I like held in all of my emotions yesterday. Just like, I was really sad come the end of the day, the very, very, very end of the day, right before bed. I just felt sad. And so, oh, this is a whole nother thing. So yesterday I ended up having like hormones. Like, I haven't had a lot of hormone issues this entire pregnancy. I haven't felt really sad, or I don't get mad easily. I get impatient, but that's kind of the extent. I don't get mad. I don't get sad. I don't have weird hormonal changes. I'm pretty mellow this whole pregnancy. I have been. But I've definitely noticed as we're creeping on to the third trimester that my hormones are changing a little bit. I'm a little bit more sensitive to stuff, and I'm not worried. Like, I at the very beginning, how I was worried about being pregnant, like, am I good enough at being pregnant? Am I doing this right? I don't have those fears anymore, and I don't really have the fear of labor and delivery anymore. I mean, it's always there, but it's not as bad as it was. I mean, we're like about to hit the home stretch, and I just had like some weird mindset. So I kind of just was having a moment yesterday. I don't know. I just had a day yesterday. So then I was like really upset going to bed last night. I just felt like hormonal and just sad. And so I just, no real particular reason per se, but just felt really sad. I was having a lot of different pregnancy pains. Like, my hips are officially starting to hurt when I laid down. And I don't know if it's so much my hips or my sciatic nerve pain. I haven't had acid reflux in like 24 hours, and now I officially do, and it hurts. So yeah, I was just having like a weird night, and then I woke up this morning and moved my foot, and I felt the bed was wet. So the cat peed on the bed. I have no idea why. I haven't been able to find her. She's hiding somewhere in this house. She knows she did something wrong. So it's just kind of been a nightmare. So I woke up to that. So it was like, I was already sad. I woke up at like 6 a.m. to go pee, and then just never fell back asleep. Come 8 a.m. I think I had just fallen asleep for maybe the past 10 minutes. 8 a.m. rolls around. I feel the pee, jump out of bed. And I just had like a really like sad night and then morning. And then it ended up being okay. I had a breakdown this morning, like after talking to my husband a little bit, like trying to, you know, like get me back on normal pages. Like, I ended up breaking down, but then after the breakdown, I felt fine. You know, I am back into a headspace of bring it on. I haven't gotten a call or anything. I would think I would get a phone call by now if they wanted me to do anything different. Yesterday was a really good day though. So it was really good up until nighttime. We watched Insidious last night, and I literally about peed myself, like legit almost peed myself multiple times because I was so afraid, and then the baby would kick and then I would almost pee myself. And I've tried not to do anything that scares me. Oh, my husband's home. I've tried not to do anything scary because I don't want to, like, I don't know, I don't want to get him worked up or anything, and I don't want to mess anything up. But we finally watched a scary movie last night, and my gosh, was it scary. But anyway, tonight we're having game night with my mom, so I'm gonna work, and then we're gonna go do game night tonight. So that'll be nice. That should be able to make me feel better. Hey, you guys. So I have no idea when the last time was that I talked to you guys. I was supposed to have a vlog up, I think, on Tuesday or Thursday. It is not up, and it's now Sunday. So today's Sunday. And lots to update you guys on, I think. I don't remember, like I said, last time I talked to you guys. Probably even on Friday I updated you guys some. I have no idea what we did. Like, literally have no idea what we did on Friday. Oh, On Friday, we went and we had game night with my parents, which was a lot of fun. We had a really good time. We played Pictionary and Family Feud, both of which was a lot of fun. And the girls won at Pictionary and the boys won at Family Feud. But the boys only won at Family Feud because I gave it to them. So there's that. And then yesterday, which was Saturday, we took our birthing class, and basically it's just a motherhood class. It's pretty much what it was called. It ended like 2 hours earlier than it was supposed to, which was awesome, but it really like flew by. So if you guys are debating on whether you should take a birthing class or not, to be honest, for my husband and I, he and I are very knowledgeable when it comes to babies. We aren't obviously parents yet, but when it comes to like things that you would learn in class or just like the basics of babies, he and I are pretty knowledgeable about it. So for he and I, the class, I would say I'm really happy we took it. I feel, you know, happy that we did. I'm happy to know, like, I'm happy to have the confidence of knowing that we know what's going on. Like, I feel confident about it. And it was really nice taking the class and meeting other people. And just, it was just a really, really good class to take. And I definitely recommend, if you're a newbie, you don't have nieces or nephews or siblings or any, you're not really ever around other babies, definitely take the course because you do learn a lot. We learned a lot about labor, which was not anything new, really. There was a couple things I learned that, like, I've been dying, like, every time I ask someone, like, what station means, or I didn't really understand the whole process of effacement and all stuff, and, like, stuff like that. I knew what dilation was, but I didn't really understand station and, like, effacement, and that's, like, was definitely like answered in the course and everything. It was just a really good class to take. We got to break after like 2 or 3 hours. We went to a lunch break and we went to Costco and we ended up buying me a new desk chair. Like I told you guys, we ended up rearranging my office and we made it the guest room. So we used to have this chair right here. That was my chair. Well, that chair, as you can see the arms, I couldn't push it in all the way. So this walkway was being like blocked, like pretty much to like right where Athena's nose is. We really only had like that much room to like walk through. So we wanted to find one that the arms either went up or it went underneath the desk. So we ended up getting this chair from Costco. It's actually pretty nice and comfy. And what I like about it is actually it's like mesh type of material. And when it comes to a leather chair, you guys, like, sure, it looks nice, although mine's all beat up, so I needed a new one anyway. But of course it looks nice, but leather chairs are so warm, especially when you're in like a really, really warm office like I am. So yeah, we ended up getting me a new chair. And like I said, we did that on our lunch break. We were near a Costco, so we went ahead and picked that up and then got like a slice of pizza. But we had like pretty much just had Chick-fil-A for breakfast, so we really weren't hungry yet. So we just like got a slice of pizza. I didn't even finish mine, like not even close. So we did that, and then after class, we came home. I had to clean a lot because the dogs are such a mess. So I had to clean up, and then we ended up going to a birthday dinner for my brother-in-law, and I got to see, you know, my nephews and everything, and that was really nice. And then after that, my mother-in-law and father-in-law wanted to go to Home Goods, and we were like, oh my gosh, that's where we're going, because we also wanted to get curtains for this room and a new rod. So we knew we wanted to go to Home Goods after Chick-fil-A and do that. So we went to Home Goods and we ended up finding a new curtain rod, which is really, really pretty. That's what it looks like. It's got like that type of end. It's kind of like a, I don't even know what the color would be considered, but anyway, so we ended up getting that curtain rod. And then while we were at Home Goods, we also found a bedding set for our room. My husband doesn't like the bedding that's in here, so he wants to put our bedding in here, and this is our old bedding. I think he doesn't like it because, number one, there's that hole that I showed you guys like in like a couple clips ago. There's a hole that all I have to do is just sew it. And then also there's like bleach stains at the top that's usually covered. So he's just being like really picky. But so we're gonna put our bedding from our room into here, and then we're gonna get the new bedding and put that in our room. And then also when we were at Home Goods, there was this step stool that my husband and I really wanted to buy our baby for, you know, the bathroom, for when he's big enough to brush his teeth and wash his hands. There was this cute little step stool we really wanted to buy like months ago. And when we were there, we were telling our father-in-law about it. We're like, yeah, there's a step stool, and we described it to him. And my husband ended up seeing it out of the corner of his eye, and he goes, oh my gosh, it's here. And we're like, no, we're not gonna end up buying it again. And my father-in-law's like, go get the step stool. And so he and my mother-in-law ended up buying it for the baby, which was really, really sweet. So we have that. And then after there, we all decided to go to Kohl's because it was right next door. So us four went to Kohl's and we ended up getting new curtains. This room is so hot, you guys. It's miserable. So we ended up getting new curtains. We got blackout ones because we need to block out the sun, obviously, for when it gets too hot. So we got these Sonoma embroidered Dynasty blackout window panels. So we got two of these to put up, and which I thought were really, really pretty. So I thought they would look really nice in here. And I'm really excited too, because there's some days that like the dogs literally just like sit at the window and stare out, and I would like to be able to like cover it up and make it more difficult for them to do it. But I just have a feeling they're gonna end up like getting these curtains dirty all the time, but I like that I can wash them. That's a plus. Yeah, we did that all yesterday, and then today has just pretty much been chilling. I put together my chair. We also bought me a step. I've been needing a step to shave my legs, because shaving my legs honestly is hurting so bad. I am suffering from sciatica. The baby is hitting some nerve, and I don't even know if it's the baby per se. It's just like the pressure of all of the like uterus expanding and putting pressure on the nerve, and you know, the amniotic fluid and all of the weight gain and stuff like that. Like, it's just putting a lot of pressure on my sciatic nerve. So I am suffering from sciatica, and it hurts so bad. And bending over is really painful now. I have a belly now, and it's really hard to just simply shave my legs. And I don't wanna not shave my legs. I have to do it. I have to. So we ended up finding this little step. I'll leave a link to it down in the description below, because I really like it, but you have to install it properly, and a lot of people don't know how. So the reviews I think are like only 3 out of 5 stars, but I really think those people are idiots, because it installs, like, it's a little bit difficult to install, but at the same time, like, it's difficult because it's made to last, and a lot of people I don't think do it right. So it's not difficult. What am I saying? It's not difficult to install, but it takes muscle, I should say, to install. But it's not difficult at all. It's actually like stupid easy. So I installed that this morning, and I love it. It's really nice. I'm really excited to have it. And it's nice because I don't have a ledge in my shower. I just have like a stand-up shower. So there's nowhere for me to like lift my leg up to have like help on the belly and relief on the back. So I'm so happy with it. And what's funny is yesterday during the like birthing class, they have like this thing called the empathy belly. And it basically has like really heavy boobs and a big, heavy, like pregnant belly. But I had my husband pretend like he was shaving his legs, because that is my biggest complaint. I don't complain a lot about pregnancy. I have a lot of sciatic nerve pain and stuff like that, which he'll never be able to obviously understand, you know, unless he ever has it. But when it comes to anything I complain a lot, it's shaving my legs. So I had him pretend, and he goes, yeah, he's like, I can see. It's pretty difficult. It sucks. I'm like, yeah, it sucks really bad. And imagine like as you're trying to lift your heavy belly, it's in the way. Try imagining having a pain shooting down your like leg and butt while you're doing it. It sucks. So yeah, it was just a really good weekend though. Like, I think right now I'm gonna run and get some errands done, because I have to buy face wash. I completely ran out. I had to use my St. Ives facial scrub as face wash last night, which is terrible. It's a terrible thing to do. Cleaning your face, like around your eyeballs with that stuff, is just awful. But I tried like my best to like pick out like the scrubbing beads and just simply use like the actual like face wash. It was a hot mess. So I need to go buy more of that. I think that's it. And then I'm gonna come back home and just take it easy. I didn't plan on leaving today, but I remembered I needed face wash. So I was like, you know what? I'll get the errands done that needs to be done, and then I'll be done for the weekend. So yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and eat a little bit of lunch, and then I'm going to get my errands done. I will get a vlog up for you guys hopefully today. It's already edited. That's the worst part. It's completely edited and ready to go. I just haven't uploaded it. That's just how bad and how crazy this week has been. Oh, I'm bleeding. How lovely is that? I scratched my heel and it's bleeding. Lovely. All right, you guys, so I am home. I ran to Target and I ran to Marshall's. I had a return to do to Marshall's. I got some face wash and I found 2 new shirts. If you go there this week, I forget what their new brand is called. It's like Alex and Easy, or A and Easy, or something like that.
their new brand. They have $5 tank tops now. And yesterday I was about to buy these maternity tank tops. And I'm like, you know what? Like, I want maternity clothes that are specific to maternity clothes, but at the same time, like things like tank tops and stuff like that. Like, I feel like us women who are pregnant, we feel like we have to wear just like maternity clothes. Like, it's all we fit in. But in reality, it's not true. Like, even this shirt is not like labeled as maternity, but it fits perfect as a maternity shirt. It's like very soft, very loose fitting, or not even loose fitting. It's like just a really good material. It feels like a maternity top, to be honest. I ended up finding these tank tops and they were so cute for $5. So I was like, you know what? If I get a bigger one, it'll fit my belly now and it'll fit my belly as I get bigger. And then hopefully it'll still somewhat fit after pregnancy because of the material it was. It's kind of like a fitted material, but like a stretchy fitted material. I don't even know how to describe it. It literally feels like a maternity type of material, I guess. But it's perfect. And so I ended up getting two new tank tops and I love them. I really want to go back and get the rest of the colors. I don't know if it's going to fit after pregnancy, but the fact that they were $5, I don't necessarily care. I'm going to be spending a lot of my uncomfortable months during pregnancy in the summertime, so I want to make sure I have a lot of clothes that I can wear that are cute, that are going to be, you know, nice and cool for the summertime. So I went ahead and got those, got face wash, got some new gum because my husband keeps stealing my gum. So I bought more gum, came home, and now I'm trying to decide what we're gonna have for dinner. I'm thinking I'm just gonna get us some subs and just have like a sub for dinner. I do not eat deli meat. I am eating chicken whenever I get Subway.